Hello guys, and welcome to this short video to discuss a little bit about panoramic radiographs, right? So, by the way, all those names are acceptable. Panoramic radiograph, orthopantomogram, or orthopantomograph, those names that you are seeing on top of myself here. The most common abbreviation is actually OPG, all right? So, when and how to use OPGs, that's the question. So, let's see a little bit about the main key points, you know, for us to use the panoramic radiographs. The first key point is we can use for teeth and surrounding anatomical structures to have a general view of the patient, okay? Of course, even though we can use this to have a panorama of the patient, we need always to use to complement our clinical evaluation, right? So we need to do our physical extraoral evaluation, our clinical intraoral evaluation, and then you guys can maybe ask for the patient to undergo a panoramic radiograph for us to diagnose multiple situations at the same time. However, we don't have the same amount of details as we have on periapical radiographs. So let's discuss a little bit about that. This is also very important. But then we have the second key point here, which is that we can use OPGs to assess the order of eruption and lesions as well, because we have a very nice view of the mandibular and maxillary alveolar ridges, right? So, for example, osteolytic lesions and cysts, we can see, you know, we could at least have a general view of this. And if, again, if we have the need of more details, then we can always take a periapical radiograph or to plan a surgery or something that we need three-dimensional information, then we can take a CBCT, which is even more common for dentistry. Right? And then we have our third key point here, which is that we cannot forget about the fact that we have magnification and distortion with OPGs, right? So, and that's why we need to have periapical radiographs when we need more details. Just for us to, you know, to use this as an example, we have this radiolucent image over here, okay, which is suggestive of, let's say, a granuloma with root resorption involved as well. But then, you know, there is also this radiolucent shadow, which belongs to the airspace of the mouth, which is being superimposed to the lesion. And that's why we need actually a periapical radiograph to assess this area properly, okay? Then we have also this lesion here, which is in the maxillary sinus, of course, and it's a dome-shaped lesion. Okay, and this lesion, for example, can be diagnosed solely using a panoramic radiograph, and that's actually an antropseudocyst, all right? So those were the key points of today to help your studies, and see you guys in the next videos.